Yo, what is happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. In the previous videos of this series, you've seen me transferring a Revit model to SketchUp, then apply materials, and finally render it with V-Ray. Today I'm gonna show you a breakdown of my post-production process in Photoshop. Let's get started. Number 1. Import render files. The first thing I do is open Photoshop and import my files that I've saved after the rendering. This includes the VFB channels and most importantly, the raw render that I will use as the base image. The VFB channels can be anything that you've chosen to export prior to your rendering. The most useful one for me is the material ID, which I have mentioned in the last video. Sometimes I also like to export other channels like the Z-depth, reflection, and refraction channels. After importing the render files as different layers, I only leave the base image on and turn all of the other VFB channels off and save them for later. Number 2. Adding the background. There are essentially two parts that make up the background. First is the sky, and second is the surrounding buildings. Adding a sky to your rendering is one of the easiest things to do in Photoshop, but I'd advise you not to overlook this part, because the sky really sets the mood for the whole image. If you want to know some tips on choosing a perfect sky for your image, Alex Hockriff wrote an amazing post on this topic. I'll put the link in the description box below so you can learn it from the master himself. The second part of the background is the surrounding buildings, which is just as important because this will show the context of the site. Without it, the viewer will question, well, what the f*** is this place? Is it on an island or is it just floating in space? Adding background buildings is necessary if you have empty spaces in your rendering like I do in this one. I didn't model anything there because sometimes it's just easier to add surrounding buildings later in Photoshop. I usually don't spend a ton of time on this. It doesn't need to be perfect because it's such a small part of the image that most people don't even notice the flaws. Number 3. Texturing the ground plane. The ground plane consists of, well, anything that's on the ground, like the grass, or additional texture that makes your rendering looks more realistic, such as these textures that I've overlaid on top of the roads and curves. Number 4. Populating your image with entourage. Adding trees, cars, and people to your image is really important because it really makes the scenery more lively and exciting. There are two ways to add these entourage in your rendering. One is by using 3D components of them in your model and render it all together. Two is to use 2D cutouts later in Photoshop. You can always use a combination of both, like for this rendering here, I found that using 3D models of the cars and 2D cutouts of the people and trees work best for me. Number 5. Using Photoshop effects to enhance your image. Now that you've got the hard stuff out of the way, it's time to have some fun and add some sweet effects to your image like fog, depth of field, tilt shift, motion blur, bloom effect, lens flare, you name it. Just add whatever feels right for you. Number 6. Final edits using plugins. Now that your image is complete, finish it off using plugins. Google has an amazing plugin for Photoshop called Google Nick Collection. It used to cost money but now is completely free, so grab it while you can and use it to make your rendering look f***ing awesome. I'll leave the link in the description box below so you can try it out yourself. I'll also leave a link of this article by Alex in which he gives some amazing tips on managing your layers in Photoshop. This video was actually inspired by that article, so I gotta give him tons of credits for that. And that's all I have for today, but that's not all I have to say about this topic. You know everything that we just went through? I will create a step-by-step tutorial for each of these processes in the upcoming weeks, so smash that subscribe button if you want to see more. Stay inspired, guys, and I will see you next time.